Hello students, welcome to the biology class. We are continuing with our chapter biomolecules, in which we have discussed the micromolecules like simple carbohydrates, lipids, amino acids, and today we are going to discuss another micromolecule, that is your nucleotides. What are nucleotides? Nucleotides are organic compounds with heterocyclic ring. They are composed of carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, and phosphorus. So this nucleotide organic compound is composed of five elements, that is carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, and phosphorus. They are the building blocks of nucleic acids, that is DNA and RNA. They occur as free molecules in the cell and play very important role in energy transfer. Components of nucleotides. Every nucleotide is consist of three components. Number one is pentose sugar, means made up of five carbons, nitrogen base, and a phosphate group. First, we are taking the pentose sugar, a ring molecule of 5 carbon pentose sugar. Number 1 is ribose and number 2 is deoxyribose. So this is the structure of ribose, in which we are having a 5 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is your 5 carbon. So we are having the group OH, OH, OH and OH. Clear? So deoxyribose is again the pentose sugar, but you can see the difference in carbon number 2. In ribose, the carbon number 2 is having H and OH, whereas in deoxyribose, the carbon number 2 is having only H and H, means one oxygen is less. The name is deoxy, means one oxygen lesser than the ribose. Both are pentose sugar because both are made up of 5 carbon compounds, but one oxygen is less in the deoxyribose, and specifically at the carbon number 2. Nitrogen bases. There are two types of nitrogen bases, that is purines and pyrimidines. They are collectively called as nitrogen bases. Purines are double ring nitrogen bases, and they include adenine and guanine. So two purines are there, that is your adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines, they have a single ring in their molecule, and they include thymine, cytosine, and uracil. So three are pyrimidines and two are purines. So here you can see the structure of your adenine and guanine, which is your double ring is there, whereas cytosine, uracil and thymine, they are single ring compounds. The last component is your phosphoric acid. 1 to 3 molecules of inorganic phosphate, that is H3PO4, which is linked to 5 carbon position of pentose. So what are nucleoside? This is very important term, that is what do you mean by nucleoside, or what is nucleoside, define nucleoside. The nitrogen base, it may be adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine or uracil, is joined to or attached to carbon number 1 of pentose sugar, and they are joined through the glycosidic bond. Nucleoside consists of pentose sugar, which may be ribose or it may be deoxyribose, and nitrogen base linked to the first carbon position of the sugar. So what is nucleoside? That is a sugar, it may be ribose or deoxyribose, and nitrogen base linked to the first carbon position of the sugar is known as nucleoside. And the base may be adenine, it may be guanine, it may be thymine, cytosine or uracil. So in this structure you can see that is your ribose sugar, and at the carbon number 1 you are having the base that is called as the adenine, that is your adenine or guanine, whatever the base is there. So this is your purines, and pyrimidines, that is you are having a cytosine, thymine or uracil. Next is your nucleotides. Now the phosphate group is linked to the 5th carbon of the pentose sugar through the phosphodiester bond. The nucleoside, that is means the sugar base, and along with the phosphate they constitute the nucleotide. So the nucleotide consists of 3 components. Number 1 is sugar base and phosphate group, and 2 bonds are present. Number 1 is glycosidic bond and number 2 is your phosphodiester bond. So the nucleotides with the ribose sugar, they are called as the ribonucleotides, that is they are building blocks of RNA. So in this structure you can see this is your pentose sugar, ribose pentose sugar. At the carbon number 1 you are having a nitrogen base, it may be A, U, C, G. A stand for adenine, U stand for uracil and C stand for cytosine and guanine. In RNA or in the ribose sugar, or you can say in the ribonucleotide, the uracil is present instead of thymine. So here we can have A, U, C and G, either of them. At the carbon number 1 with the help of a glycosidic bond, and at the carbon number 5 that is having the phosphate group, and this is known as your ribonucleotide, and they are the building blocks of the RNA. Similarly, deoxyribonucleotides, the nucleotides with deoxyribose sugar, they are called as the deoxyribonucleotides, and they are the building blocks of the DNA. In this you are having a deoxyribose sugar, that is the base, it is adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine, and at the carbon number 5 we are having the phosphate. Function of the nucleotides. Nucleotides, they can act as a coenzymes. Coenzyme is non-protein organic molecule which has to combine with particular enzyme to make it functional. Some nucleotides present in the cell function as coenzymes. A coenzyme has some vitamins such as nicotinamide and riboflavin as one of its constituents attached to the pentose sugar and one or more phosphates. The nucleotides which function as coenzymes are NAD, NADP, FMN and FAD. So what are the full form of these coenzymes? That is flavin adenine dinucleotide, then nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, which function as a coenzymes and they give energy to the metabolic reactions. So what are nucleotides and what are nucleosides? That is, what is the difference between the nucleoside and nucleotide? Nucleoside is sugar plus base at the carbon number 1, whereas nucleotide is a sugar base plus phosphate group at the carbon number 5. So this is a major difference between the nucleoside and nucleotide, and polymerization of nucleotide will form the building blocks of your nucleic acid depending upon the sugar. If it is ribose sugar or ribonucleotide, then RNA is there. And if it is deoxyribonucleotides, the polymerization of deoxyribonucleotides will form the DNA. With this, we finish our micromolecules, in which we have discussed about the sugar, lipids, amino acids and nucleotides. And in our next lesson, we will start with our macromolecules, in which we discuss about the polysaccharides, proteins, and nucleic acid. Till then, stay home, stay happy. Thank you.